More than 30 title of the Human Rights Declaration, the SPDC committed. One thing we can do to struggle for our rights is to collect information about the human rights abuse and forced labor, various forms of forced labor in our community. When they know their rights, when we educate them about the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, they know more about, or at least all our rights they really face in the current situation. Forced relocation, rape, looting, forced labor, and demanded money if you cannot serve as porters or workers for army garrison. Abuses, usually looting. I think when the SPDC enter into this villages, they usually demanded domestic animals, and then they took it without pay. And then in the forest, when they saw the domestic animal of the villagers, they shot and killed. And then they shot and killed the buffaloes and cattle used for farming. And then they take it for food. And then they force the people to carry ammunition for them, and then strictly guarded them by the soldiers. And they were not treated well during going for portage. They did not get enough food, and then they did not get well treated by the soldiers. And sometimes they committed rape on the women. Like this, they sent all the information to the local authority. You can say the village lead, head of village, and some, and also to any officer. And we receive many documents on SPDC human rights violation, especially in the summer time. The SPDC usually launch an operation, and then whatever they see, they loot it and they burn down and destroy. In the area when the SPDC control, they every year they have to pay food to the SPDC as they demanded. And maybe 15 baskets per acre. And some area where the paddy can produce more, up to 20 baskets per acre, have to sell it to the government with the government fee rate. It is one basket. Most of the problem they face is forced labor, especially the place where the SPDC set up their position in that area. They confiscated the land for the army, confiscated a large area of land to set up the headquarters. And then even in the farm land, they did not pay for compensation. They use it for the military. And then to get better communication, they force the people to make a road for them, to build road for them, to get a stone together, to make earth on the road. And then they use the wood, the villagers, to make fans, to dig bunkers, to make trench for the military. And they would force the villagers to bring bamboo, wood, leaf root, roots for the army barrack. Any condition is need hard work to clear rice and to look after carefully of the plants. And they do not have enough time because they have to do for the army. So, especially now in the Tangut district, the people were forced all the time. Even the women with their babies, when the men cannot available, they use the women to carry ration for them. Because in our current area, there is no factory, no workshop, no motor road, no railroad. So when we go on organizing, we have to walk on foot, and carry with our bags, with our food. So we organize the people from place to place and educate them about union movement. So the most problem for the agriculture workers are the porters and forced labor. 80%, 90% of our current population are the farm workers, agriculture workers. In the region, as you know, mountainous region, and there is no road. So they have to use the porters instead of motor car, instead of mules, horse. So they use the men and women to carry for them all the time. And sometimes in the area where they could control very well, they inform the village heads to gather 10 persons per village, for instance, 15 persons from village to come to the army outpost to go for porters. If the village head cannot provide the porters for them, they have to pay for money. One for 5,000 baht. 6,000 baht, sorry, jat, the Burmese currency, jat, you have to pay for the forest fees. But in the rural area, I mean in the IDP area, they use forcibly the people to carry for them. Any person, a woman or men or children, they force them and to carry for them. Because in the jungle, in the rural area, they force them to work for them without any request to the village leaders. In the hill region, from place to place, it is we can go for 1 day trip and come back in 2 days like this. Sometimes they force the people for a long time to carry, to go along with them in the jungle according to the distance, 1 day trip, or sometimes 1 week or 1 month. So when would they go on operation and they force the people to go along with them in the operation period, within 2 months or 3 months, like this, you have to follow them. There's only food, but not enough food. Their soldiers have enough food. But for porters, they have only one plate of food and with salt. And if the rural people, they understand how to collect vegetables which are good for food and gather food, vegetables and make with salt and rice, they have. But only one plate of food.
Okay.
Yeah, per day. When they cannot carry hard burden for the soldiers, and then they were ill-treated by the soldiers. Sometimes they kick them down to the hill and there. And sometimes the porters are coming from the city or town and then they do not use to walk in the hill region, and then they feel tired and cannot follow the other colleagues. At that time, the soldiers treated them not very well, and sometimes they kick them down to the slopes and then they died. Then nobody wants to participate in their labor, in their work, because the situation is worse than currently, as you know, because they are authoritarian military regime and they don't want to hand over power to the NLD, which is elected by the people.